Hey, in this video, I'm going to show you how to make use of JSP built-in server objects. So with built-in server objects, these are given to you for free. So there's no need to create them. You can simply use them directly in your JSP page. And you've actually played around with some of this earlier, and I'll show you this on the next slide. So here's a list of the commonly used JSP server objects. So starting here at the top with request, it contains information about the HTTP request headers and also form data. We're going to use this a lot in some of the following videos for reading form data. There's also the response object for sending back HTTP specific information, and we'll use this also in the following video on making use of cookies. Now, this one server object you used already, the out object, and we use that for our out.print line in one of the previous videos. So again, a built-in server object given to you for free. Now, there's two others here. Session, it's a unique session for each user. You can kind of think of the session object as kind of like a shopping cart. You know, each user has their own unique shopping cart. We'll use this on a following video. And finally, there's the application object. So this is shared for all users of a given web app. And I'll discuss various use cases on how to use the application object. Now, just a full disclaimer, this is not an exhaustive list. There are other server objects out there, but these are the ones that are most commonly used for JSP web apps. All right, so here's the idea. You have a browser communicating with the JSP. Behind the scenes, the HTTP protocol, they actually send over a request object. This request object contains header information and body information. The JSP can perform some work on that information and then send back a response. So we have the whole request response protocol going. In the demo, I'll actually show you how to make use of the request object. All right, so let's go ahead and move into Eclipse. What I'd like to do is continue to use the existing project, JSP demo. And I'd like to move down to the folder here, web content, because we're actually going to create a new file. So I just do a right click, I say new file. Now the name I'll give here, I'll call it builtin-test.jsp because we're, of course, testing some of the built-in objects. And once you're happy with the name, we'll go ahead and click finish. Okay, great. So let's expand the window here for a second. And we have a blank file, we need to start writing some code. So again, I start off with my HTML and my body information. I'll just set up a header 3 just to give us a little name here for the page. And now what I want to do is I actually want to read some information about the request. So I want to find out what type of browser the user is using to access my JSP page. So you can access this information using the request object. So I can say request.getHeader, and then you can give the header name of user agent. So this will tell you the actual browser that the client is using. Also, it'll tell you the operating system that they're running on. So let me go ahead and add some line breaks here. And now I also want to find out what language the client is making use of in their browser. So if they're using English, Spanish, German, French. So here I say request.getLocale. And this will give me the actual locale that the user has set up on their system. So we could use this to customize the type of pages we send the user based on their actual locale, like English or German or Spanish. And that's basically it for this very basic demo here. So go ahead and save your file, and let's go ahead and run this program. So I'll move to the file builtin-test.jsp. I'll do a right click, and I'll say run as, and then run on server. Okay, great. So the application runs. Note here, request user agent. So they'll tell us the type of browser that's coming through. So here we're using this internal browser that's built in as part of this Eclipse tool. But note it also says that we're using a Mac OS X. So we know the operating system and the browser that the user is running on. Let me copy this information and put it into a different browser. I'll drop it into Chrome and I'll just paste it. And I'll just hit enter. And so now we get the same information, but note here it says Chrome. So they give us the actual Chrome browser that we're using in the version, Mac OS, and also the request language is English. So again, you could possibly use this to customize the different pages you want to send back to the user based on their browser type, OS type, or their language type. So good job. An example of using that built-in request object. Okay, great. Let's go ahead and wrap up this video. In this video, I showed you how to use some of the built-in server objects. We may use the request object to find out the user's operating system and browser. In the following videos, we'll do a drill down into some of the other objects, and you can kind of see them working out real world for the various use cases.